Vietnam Weekly News Highlights.
Public investment pushes real estate market. Vietnam's GDP, FDI, and overseas investments has witnessed a growth over 9 months. Foreign firms expand investment in Vietnam. Vietnam ranks 73rd for digital quality of life, e-security improves. Vietnam emerges as fast-growing real estate market in Southeast Asia. The Ministry of Transport plans to reopen domestic routes. The acceleration of investment in transport infrastructure is the main driving force fueling real estate stocks, as many businesses with large land plots located in areas near key infrastructure projects will benefit from this process. The government has released the medium-term public investment plan for the 2021 to 2025 period, with a total capital of up to VND 2.87 quadrillion, $120 billion, an increase of 43% compared to the 2016 to 2020 period. The capital is mainly for investment in transport infrastructure in provinces. According to Viet Dragon Securities Co., the total infrastructure investment in the 2021 to 2025 period in Hanoi is VND 3.32 trillion, Ho Chi Minh City VND 638.5 trillion, and Dong Nai VND 595 trillion. In the south, it is apparent that most of the key infrastructure projects under construction or planning will pass through Dong Nai province, namely Long Thanh International Airport, Ben Luc, Long Thanh Expressway, Bien Hoa, Phung Tau Expressway, and Dao Ji, Phan Thiet Highway. Vietnam's gross domestic product, GDP, expanded by 1.42% in the first 9 months of 2021 from the same period last year. Vietnamese overseas investment during the opening 9 months of the year surged by 32.4% on year to reach $572.3 million. According to the Ministry of Planning and Investment, a total of 41 new projects received investment licenses, with registered capital reaching over $150.1 million, equivalent to 55.9% compared to the same period from last year. Despite COVID-19 impacts, foreign direct investment FDI inflows into Vietnam during the first 9 months of this year rose 4.4% year-on-year to $22.15 billion, reported the Foreign Investment Agency under the Ministry of Planning and Investment. Foreign company Nestle continued to expand in Vietnam since they see the country's COVID-19 setbacks as temporary. Nestle has announced a $132 million investment in the next 2 years to build a new plant in the southern province of Dong Nai. This is part of its long-term vision as it sees Vietnam as a regional and global manufacturing hub. CEO of Nestle Vietnam, Binu Jacob, said at a forum Monday, "There have been temporary difficulties caused by the increasing costs of the stay-at-work model and disruptions in the supply chain. But Vietnam remains one of Nestle's top manufacturing facilities globally," he said. The new investment would help create new products for the Asian-Pacific markets, he said. Vietnam's e-security index improved by 54% since last year, but its internet became less affordable. The 2021 Digital Quality of Life Index, DQL, conducted by cybersecurity company Surfshark showed. The third annual report has placed Vietnam 73rd among 110 countries, down 19 places compared to the previous year, covering 90% of the global population. The study evaluates countries based on 5 fundamental digital well-being pillars. Vietnam shows its best results in internet affordability, ranking 51st, but lags behind with internet quality, 86th, e-government, 75th, e-security, 71st, and e-infrastructure, 67th. Residential real estate in Vietnam is still one of the fastest-growing markets in Southeast Asia, despite the fact that the COVID-19 pandemic has halted many economic activities, according to experts from property consultant Savills Vietnam. Troy Griff, deputy managing director of Savills Vietnam, said that investing in the real estate market in Vietnam continues to be the choice of many investors. The market still enjoyed a year-on-year increase of 270% in the new supplies in the first 2 quarters of this year.
The apartment market in Hanoi recorded an increase in prices for 10 consecutive quarters. Notably, the primary price of apartments in Co Chi district has increased by 14% per year since 2017. In Ho Chi Minh City, the primary supply is limited, but the low-rise real estate segment is still quite good, with the secondary price increase of 15 to 20% in districts 7, 9, and Nha Be. The Ministry of Transport plans to reopen domestic flights in four phases in which epidemic prevention is eased from October 1, Phase 1, up to 10 days from the date of application of the plan. The frequency on each route with each airline does not exceed 50% of the average of the first 10 days of April and an empty middle seat on the plane. Phase 2, up to 10 days after Phase 1, frequency on each route of each airline does not exceed 70%. Phase 3, after Phase 2, the frequency on each route of each airline does not exceed the average frequency of the first 10 days of April and does not have to empty middle seat. Phase 4, new normal, allows carriers to operate back to normal situations. In addition, it is known that the director of the Civil Aviation Authority of Vietnam, Dinh Viet Thanh, proposed to open flights to bring passengers from Hanoi by airport. The opposite direction will only carry goods.
Hanoi Weekly News Highlights.
Overall adjustment of the capital construction master plan to 2030 and a vision to 2050. Approving the architectural plan of the new administrative center in west of West Lake. Hanoi to renovate degraded apartment blocks by 2025. Bac Ninh, Hung Yen together spend money to urge the progress of Ring Road 4. Proposal to invest 1,700 billion VND to build a new Duong Bridge. It is expected to operate two electric bus lines in October.
Chairman of the City People's Committee Chu Nak On has just signed Decision 4199/QDUBND on assigning the task of organizing the formulation of the overall adjustment of the Hanoi Capital Construction Master Plan to 2030 with a vision to 2050. The Hanoi Institute of Construction Planning is responsible for presiding over and coordinating with the Department of Planning and Architecture, city departments and agencies, the People's Committees of Districts to organize the formulation of the overall adjustment tasks and projects. General planning on construction of the capital in strict accordance with the law on planning, urban planning, public investment, and relevant legal provisions, advise the City People's Committee to consider and submit to competent authorities for appraisal and approval. The Ministry of Construction recently decided to choose five planning ideas and overall architecture for the construction of West of West Lake area in Hanoi to submit to the government for last decision. The idea Tang Long Green Galaxy won the A prize. The overall planning and architecture design and planning unit is a Japanese joint venture. The project to build working offices of 12 central ministries and branches is located along the Ring Road 2 connecting the central area directly to the international airport, with an area of about 35 hectares, adjacent to West Lake to the east, west, Red River to the north. According to the plan, 12 ministries and branches will move their headquarters to the new administrative center in this area. Dangerous and degraded residential apartment blocks in Hanoi will be renovated by 2025. The plan is part of a project on renovation and reconstruction of old apartment buildings in Hanoi, which was endorsed by the Hanoi People's Council on September 30. This project, implemented during the 2021-25 period, aims to eliminate unsafe and degraded real estate and improve the city's urban environment and people's lives. Data of the Hanoi Department of Construction showed Hanoi has nearly 1,600 old apartment buildings constructed between 1960 and 1994, some of which were even built before 1954. The city is reviewing to add about 200 to 300 properties to the list. Instead of dividing the project into seven sections and calling for investors to participate with a total investment of more than 130 trillion VND as the original plan, the Ring Road 4 has just been established by the investor Vingroup proposal to divide the route into three component projects to prepare implementation documents. The total investment for this option is more than 94,000 billion VND, down more than 36,000 billion VND compared to the original plan, reported by the City People's Committee to the Hanoi Party Committee. The Hanoi People's Committee said that, out of more than 94.000 billion VND invested in this route, localities such as Bac Ninh and Hung Yen provinces have had a policy to join Hanoi to build Ring Road 4, specifically with three investment phases, in which component project 1, out of 24,242 billion VND for site clearance, Hung Yen province spends about 3,140 billion VND, Bac Ninh province spends about 2,950 billion VND, Hanoi City spends about 18,140 billion VND.
On September 27, A representative of the Ministry of Transport said that Project Management Board 6 has just proposed to the ministry to appraise and approve the investment policy of the project to upgrade the Duong River waterway. In the 2021 to 2025 period, the project consists of building a new railway bridge about 16 meters upstream away from the existing Duong Bridge, and building a new bridge according to the plan, thereby separating the road bridge from the railway. The structure of the two works uses steel arch bridges. The railway bridge will raise the top of the track to about 2.75 m to ensure navigation. The old Duong Bridge has its beams and abutments removed to ensure smooth waterway traffic. Estimated total project investment is 1,793 billion VND, of which the cost of site clearance is 776 billion VND. Construction cost is 680 billion VND. The rest is for project management. The project is expected to be implemented from now to 2025. The first electric bus route is My Dinh Bus Station, Ocean Park Gialam Urban Area. The second route is Jiap Bat Bus Station, Smart City Urban Area. Electric vehicles used are manufactured and assembled by VinFast Company at the Automobile Production Complex in Haiphong. Equipped with many modern technologies, smart and safety features, the car has a green-friendly design as the main color, affirming the direction of investment and development of the ecosystem of smart transport vehicles using green energy, being environmentally friendly and protecting VinFast's community health, and it named VinBus. Ho Chi Minh Weekly News Highlights. Production, trading and services in Ho Chi Minh City to reopen on Friday. Thursday Tam Tu Bridge expected to be put into operation by April 2022. Panasonic launches new factory in Binh Duong Province. How Ho Chi Minh City helps businesses recover after a long lockdown. The Municipal People's Committee announced at a meeting on Thursday its plan for safe and flexible adaptation and effective control of the COVID-19 pandemic for the new normal period after September 30th. Under the plan, production facilities, enterprises and services are licensed to reopen if they meet the safety requirements of pandemic prevention and control. They must ensure that only employees with a COVID-19 green card, partly and fully vaccinated people, or people who have fully recovered from the virus, are allowed back to work. The Thursday Tam Tu Bridge project is expected to be completed by April 30, 2022, said Tran Ba Duong, chairman of Dai Quang Minh Real Estate Investment JSC, as the owner of the project. On September 30, the secretary of the Ho Chi Minh City Party Committee Nguyen Van Ninh, municipal chairman Phan Van Mai, municipal vice chairman Lu Hoa Bin, and other officials inspected the construction site of the project. Duong said work on the project went on even during holidays and the COVID-19 pandemic, and it was 85% complete. The project, once in place, will connect the city's current business hub with the Thursday Tam Tu urban area in Thursday Duc City, encourage the development of the eastern tech-driven urban area, and contribute to reducing traffic congestion in the city. Japanese tech giant Panasonic has completed a new factory in Binh Duong Province in southern Vietnam and will start production and shipment of the ceiling and ventilating fans from October 13th. This is the first factory in Panasonic Group to handle this product category in Vietnam, aiming to improve indoor air quality to better people's lives and promote the sustainable development of the country. In the future, a research and development department will also be established, allowing the site to integrate development, manufacturing, and sales. Located on a site of 49,995 square meters in Binh Duong, the new factory has a gross floor area of 24,066 SQM, which can be expanded in the future, with a total investment of $45 million. The site is expected to become a major production hub in the region, producing ventilating products, not only for the Vietnamese market, but also for the whole of Southeast Asia, the Middle East, and Africa. The People's Committee of Ho Chi Minh City has just contributed some opinions on the reduction of corporation tax, value-added tax, and land rent, the extension of tax payment deadlines, and interest rate support to the draft decree stipulating some solutions to support enterprises and people affected by the COVID-19 pandemic. Specifically, Ho Chi Minh City proposed to reduce 50% of corporate tax in 2021, and continue to cut 30% of corporate tax in 2022 and 2023 for businesses with annual revenue of less than NT$200 billion, allow all costs related to pandemic prevention and control of enterprises, such as costs for COVID-19 testing and medical treatment, if any, food and living expenses, personal protective equipment, including masks, face shields, and disinfectants, and hotel costs for isolation, to be deducted from the expenses of corporation tax. Ho Chi Minh City also asked to reduce the value-added tax rate by 50%, or the percentage rate, of the last 3 months of 2021 and the years 2022 and 2023. As for land rent, Ho Chi Minh City put forward to lower land rent by 50% in 2021 for all businesses. As for those in the tourism and tourism-related industries, land rent in 2021 will be cut 100%.